In fact, I can think of every country in Europe having one major band, from, say, Switzerland with Yellow or Germany with Kraftwerk and that. But when you stick them all together in Cork over 3 days, I think it works really well. Because Ian's been at two of these things before and brought over an Irish band to both. I've only been at one. And I started one in Liverpool a good few years back. I thought it was great. You can really get a different sort of feel, a different sort of smell of music than you normally see in the music papers or on television programmes or anything else. And there's plenty of, here goes the cliche, good rock music out there in Europe. And we're seeing it in Cork this weekend.
Cork is a very manageable place to run things. We can get top quality venues in Cork at affordable prices, something we certainly couldn't do in Dublin. And the other big advantage is that because it's a smaller place, we can run two venues, a hotel, a conference centre, and everybody can walk from one place to the other and be anywhere they need to be within 5 minutes. And you just can't do that in Dublin. And to bring people in from the continent and ship them around in taxis all over Dublin, on buses around Dublin, just isn't practical. Do it in Cork, do it where everybody can walk everywhere and they can walk around the place and look at what's going on and they can see what's happening, and it's so much friendlier and smaller and more compact.
Bands like Sugar Cubes have shown, you know, that there is a lot of good bands in Europe, and you know, through Europe it's going to be exposed a lot more, and I'm sure there's a lot of really good bands out there, and you know, through this, you know, they get the chance to play in countries where they would never get a chance before.
Ian, now you've recently come back from London. How is life for Power Dreams in London?
Well, it's essential for us to be in London for the time being, because that's where the record company is, and that's where, you know, the centre of everything is, really, in the music business. So, as regards day-to-day living, it's fine. I think we're coping fairly well with it. We're being well looked after.
Now, Craig, people always talk about Power Dreams. They're very young. It's all happening too soon. Was there any problems with your agent while you were in London?
Not in London. I mean, we didn't find really many problems at all. I mean, obviously being away from home, and like Keith's only like 17, so I mean, you know, he got a bit homesick initially, but I mean, it's a bit to be expected, you know. But I mean, he's learned to cope with it, and you know, you really look forward to getting home and stuff. But I mean, age-wise, hasn't really affected him. Hasn't been caused as much trouble at all.
Ian, 2FM nominated Power of Dreams to take part in Euro Rock. Were you pleased about that?
Yeah, it was great to be asked. There's a lot of good bands in Ireland, and it's just nice to be asked out of all of that crowd, you know? It's great.
What do you hope to be doing in 1992, the year of European Union? Where can you see Power of Dreams?
Hopefully on to our toured album, I'd imagine we would be. I'd imagine fairly successful as well. And we're quite confident about, you know, how the future's going and how it's happening at the moment. I mean, it's been steady, and we're building steady, and this time next year we'll be twice as big as we are now. So, I mean, it's by 1992, we expect to be, you know, fairly big.
Great. Jo-Maxi wishes you all the best. Thanks a lot.